Dear colleagues, animals are not disposable equipment. Inflicting pain and suffering on them has no place in 21st century science. For many of us, this is an ethical and moral imperative. And we see that despite minimum standards, cruel practices still take place within the Union. Just a couple of months ago, we witnessed video footage revealing shocking levels of cruelty and animal suffering that breach European animal testing laws. Findings from a major investigation in Spanish contract testing laboratory Vivotecnica show deliberate acts of cruelty and repeated bad practice. And all of this happens only 18 months after similar findings were revealed in a German laboratory. And even health scientists are questioning the reliability of animal studies. Let me quote the British Medical Journal, which says that the claim that animal experimentation is essential to medical development.
Colleague, again, the interpretation is not working.
Okay. Let me know if I can continue.
Ça fonctionne? Ça fonctionne en français? I think.
Okay. So science and morality point into the very same conclusion. There are cruelty-free alternatives like computational biology that can enable us to get rid of animal testing once and for all. But ever since I started looking into these issues, I kept on hearing that complete change is impossible, and I get it. Old habits die hard, and I even accept that this won't happen by the stroke of our pen. Is doing better than the rest of the world, but even here, progress is way too slow. We need a credible plan, a plan with measures, targets, and a binding, ambitious timeline. We need to promote and fund cruelty-free alternatives. We want to see increased funding for animal-free research methods and new advanced non-animal models under the Horizon Europe, and then we have to start creating testing bans. This is what our citizens demand. 7 in 10 adults in EU member states believe that enabling the full replacement of all forms of animal testing with non-animal testing methods should be a priority for the EU. And this is what we are asking from the Commission. Thank you very much.
Thank you, colleague Cseh, and sorry for the interruption, but I think it was the connection between here and the booths, and we try to bridge it now with the new microphone.